In springtime, Rusty loves to visit a faraway place. It's filled with bluebells. The air smells sweet and Rusty thinks there is no better place to be. One day, Thomas was passing by just as Rusty was having a drink.
Beep, beep, good morning,
whistled Thomas.
Your driver looks a little worried.
I wonder why.
I don't know, said Rusty, but I soon will.
Excuse me, said Rusty, but is something wrong?
Yes, indeed, replied the driver. They need another engine to help run this special line.
A bluebell engine, laughed Rusty. Maybe I can find one.
Later, Rusty saw Douglas and Percy. Rusty had an idea.
Can you help me find another engine?
Where?
Where you found Oliver?
You mean on the other railway?
Yes, I'm looking for a bluebell engine, said Rusty, and explained everything.
I'd like to help, but these days it's only diesels that go there.
Then Rusty decided,
so that's where I'll go.
Take care, warned Douglas.
Rusty told the driver all about the plan. And that night, he came back to the shed.
The manager says he'll make a home for a bluebell engine if you find one.
Right, said Rusty. We'll find one tomorrow.
It took them all of the next day to travel to the other railway.
Darkness fell and the cold wind blew.
Ooh, what's that?
Murmured Rusty. But it was only the sounds of the lonely scrapyard. Diesels, silent and still, lined up on guard.
Who are you?
Rusty plucked up courage.
I'm a shed and sidings inspection diesel. Have you any engines in the shed?
No, no.
Rusty rallied again.
Then, what about the sidings?
One. We have one.
Rusty grew braver still.
Then I'll just go and inspect.
A small engine with a tall funnel stood sad and alone in the shadowy siding. His driver was huddled in the cab, keeping him company.
Excuse me, said Rusty. Do you like bluebells?
The engine looked startled.
Yes, bluebells are beautiful.
Then you're soon going to see lots of them because I'm getting you out of here. Everyone worked fast. It was difficult to set the fire, but soon it was glowing hot and Stepney had a good head of steam. Rusty's engineer agreed to be Stepney's fireman. So off they set, past the bleak and brooding line of diesels.
Where is he going?
They hissed.
Just down the line, replied Rusty.
And they chuffered quickly away.
We've done it. We're over the border and back on our own railway. Mission accomplished.
When Rusty and the engine arrived in the valley, a big welcome awaited them.
We shall mend you and give you a new coat of paint, said the manager.
His driver was delighted. You lucky old engine. You've been saved by the Bluebell Railway.
And my friend Rusty, I wouldn't be here if it weren't for Rusty.
Now the little engine is as happy as can be and helps all the passengers who visit at Bluebell time. His name is Stepney, but everyone calls him the Bluebell Engine.
Thomas the Tank Engine was feeling very happy. His blue coat shone in the sun, he was right on time, and all around his branch line the countryside seemed prettier than ever before.
Beep, beep.
Good morning, Percy,
he whistled.
My branch line is the pride of the line, wouldn't you agree?
Yes, Thomas, of course, but...
But what, Percy? Out with it. Well, there is another engine with a famous branch line, too.
Who? Where?
Exclaimed Thomas anxiously. His name's Stepney. He's far away, but the Fat Controller says he may visit us.
When?
Oh, someday.
And Percy hurried away.
Meanwhile, Stepney was puffing purposefully along his line. It runs through fields and forests, but isn't very long, which made him feel a little sad. Later, he saw Rusty. The little diesel had helped save Stepney from scrap. Everyone's been so kind, but my railway is so short and I do miss a good long run.
I think you should tell driver too, replied Rusty. I'm sure he'll understand.
Stepney soon discovered that indeed he did. Do you know, Stepney, I feel just the same way. That evening, Stepney's driver had exciting news.
Guess what, Stepney? The Fat Controller has invited us to visit the other engines on his railway.
Manager agreed. It'll be a really long run to get there.
Oh, thank you,
sighed Stepney. They set off next morning.
By now, all the other engines were talking about Stepney.
He runs a famous branch line. Did you know that?
Said Percy. Thomas was feeling a little jealous. Huh,
it may be famous, but my branch is first on the line. Everyone knows that, too.
And he huffed away to fetch his coaches.
Look, squeaked Percy. Why have they all come? There is no train yet.
But Percy was wrong. The signal dropped and from far away an engine whistled.
Here he comes,
yelled Douglas. Stepney puffed proudly through the junction. All the engines were pleased to see him.
I hope you'll meet Thomas too, said Edward. You both have branch lines to be proud of.
Then Stepney set off to help Duck shunt coaches in the yards, and they worked happily together all afternoon. At last, Thomas arrived.
Sorry, can't talk. It's time for my last branch line train. Mustn't be late.
He was hardly out of sight when the engines heard shouting at the station. Moments later came the alarm.
Stop all trains!
The signalman answered the telephone.
A special, is it?
I see.
Thomas was impatient. Why are we waiting? My passengers are being delayed.
Sorry, Thomas, said his driver. We're being shunted to allow another train to pass. Soon, they heard an unfamiliar puffing sound.
There was Stepney with headlamps swaying and whistle blowing. He gathered speed and disappeared.
Well, bust my boiler,
said Thomas the Tank Engine.
Next morning, Thomas was still fuming.
Shunted, and on my own branch too. It's a disgrace.
I'm sorry, said Stepney. I was a special.
Why?
An important passenger arrived just as you left. He ordered a special train and Duck let me take it. We had a splendid run, but... But, finished Thomas kindly, it can make an engine nervous not to know the line.
Exactly, said Stepney.
You're such an expert. This made Thomas feel much better.
He couldn't be cross anymore and instead began telling Stepney all about his branch line.
Stepney the Bluebell engine was busy talking to the other engines. It was his first visit to their railway and he was having a splendid time.
You are very lucky engines, he said. Your line has got everything. It's long enough to give you a good run and you have plenty of passengers. Then you have a quarry and a mine, so you need plenty of trucks.
Trucks are fun. I miss them on our line.
Percy was surprised.
All the engines thought trucks were trouble.
You're welcome to take some of mine, he said.
But you'd better ask driver first.
The drivers agreed and the two engines set off.
Thomas and Toby were speechless. Stepney took the trucks to the harbour. Then he picked up a load of empty ones and started back. Ahead was a cricket field. The game had just begun. Stepney and his driver had to wait at a signal.
Good, said his driver. We can watch the game.
Then there was trouble. The batsman hit the ball. It flew high into the sky towards Stepney's train. Clunk went the signal. Thump went the ball into a truck. But neither driver nor fireman heard it.
Stop! Yelled the players.
But Stepney didn't hear them.
Come along, he puffed to the trucks. Our one and only ball, cried the players. Wake up, Caroline, they said to their old car. The chase is on.
Caroline coughed crossly and rolled down the road. Stepney wasn't hurrying. Caroline soon came up behind him.
Toot! Toot!
She wailed. The players shouted, but Stepney was still too far away for his driver and fireman to see or hear properly. They completely misunderstood.
If those jokers want a race, said the driver, they can have one. Faster, Stepney, faster. Poor Caroline wasn't happy at all. She rattled along at twice her usual speed. I shouldn't be treated like this, she grumbled. This pace is too hot for my system. It'll fuse all my circuits.
Suddenly, Stepney was nowhere to be seen.
Hurrah! Cried Caroline. That silly train has run into a hole so we can't catch it. I can go home now.
But she couldn't. Her driver pounded Caroline on up the steep hill and then down the other side towards the station. Stepney was already there when Caroline cluttered in.
We need our ball back, cried the players
and explained everything. The ball was nestled under some straw in the third truck from the van.
We found it, cried a player.
We're sorry, sighed the driver.
Oh, you couldn't help it, replied the player.
Now we must get back quickly.
You'll be lucky, said the driver.
Caroline looks worn out. And she was. The driver spoke to the station master and the signalman, and they all agreed a plan. Soon, they had rolled Caroline onto a flat truck with a brake van coupled behind. The players crowded inside and Stepney pulled the train back to the playing field. Everyone enjoyed watching the game. Even Caroline was pleased. She doesn't think trains silly now.
They have their uses, she says. They can save the wear on a poor car's wheels.
Stepney's visit to the Fat Controller's Railway was coming to an end.
We shall miss you,
said the Fat Controller. Then he turned his attention to all the other engines.
My railway is very busy and I am pleased with you, but you need help. A diesel is all that's available. Please do your best to avoid any, disturbances.
What does that mean? Whispered Duck.
That means this diesel is difficult, snapped James.
And he was. The diesel surveyed the shed. Not bad, I've seen worse. At least you're all clean, he sneered. The engines glared. It's not your fault, but your controller should scrap you and get engines like me. A fill of oil, a touch on the starter, and I'm off. No bother, no waiting. They have to fuss around you for hours before you're ready.
The engines were furious.
Next morning, they held an indignation meeting round the turntable.
Disgraceful, mumbled Gordon.
Disgusting,
said James.
Despicable, spluttered Henry.
To say such things to us, cried Donald and Douglas. It's to teach him a lesson we'd be wanting. Now how do we do it?
Their chance came sooner than expected. The diesel was purring comfortably. An inspector watched the fitter making final adjustments. The wind tugged at the inspector's hat. The diesel was ready.
Look at me, Duck and Stepney. Now I'll show you something.
He rolled proudly towards his coaches.
Then it happened. Shaking and spluttering, the diesel stopped.
Meanwhile, the inspector was looking for his hat. The diesel seethed with fury as Duck and Stepney pushed him back to the shed.
My hat! Exclaimed the inspector. You've sucked it through your air intake.
Bother your hat, said the Fat Controller. The heavy train's due out. You'll have to take it, Doc. Stepney, will you help, please?
Thank you, sir, cried Stepney. I'd like a good long run on my last day. The engines were soon ready.
Gordon will take over from halfway, so get the train there. Good luck.
Don't worry, smiled Stepney.
We'll get there and be early, too.
The cavalcade moved carefully over the rails and out to the open line.
Now for a sprint, puffed Stepney.
I'm ready when you are, replied Duck. Soon they were whizzing through Edward's station. And next, they charged at Gordon's Hill beyond.
They felt the drag of the heavy coaches here. It was hard work. At last, they were running smoothly along the line towards the big station.
Hello, said Gordon. You're early. That's one in the headlamp for old Diesel.
James says he's sick as boiler sludge and sulking in the shed.
Serves him right for saying we're out of date.
And Gordon chortled away.
Next day, everyone came to say goodbye to Stepney.
Come back and see us soon,
whistled the engines.
And you are always welcome on my Bluebell Railway too, replied Stepney. Then he puffed away.
And what about Diesel?
He'd slipped out whilst no one was looking. He said goodbye to no one but left two things behind.
A rather nasty smell and a battered bowler hat.
Stepney, the Bluebell engine, works closely with his friend Rusty. One day, the Fat Controller came to see him.
Rusty tells me you're in need of change, so I want you to help Toby and Mavis in the quarry.
Oh, thank you, sir, said Stepney. Shall I be away long?
Just today, replied the Fat Controller. But please be careful, it's easy to get lost up there, so be back before dark.
We will, said the driver. Stepney soon arrived at the quarry.
We're glad you're here to help us, said Toby.
Are those my trucks? Asked Stepney eagerly.
Only some of them. There's masses more in the sidings, replied Mavis.
The more the merrier, whistled Stepney.
Stepney was really enjoying himself. The dustier he became, the harder he worked. Mavis and Toby were impressed. The quarry foreman spoke to his driver.
We have a night special to take to the building site at the new branch line. Do you want to pull the train?
Yes, please, said the driver.
But he should have asked the Fat Controller first.
Night came.
Be careful, Stepney, advised Toby.
I will, and thank you for a lovely day. I do hope I can come back again.
The line can be spooky, said Mavis.
Thank you for the warning. And with that, Stepney puffed away into the night. Stepney arrived on time and made the delivery of rock and stones for the workmen. Then he set off for home. That's when the trouble began. The fog came down. Mavis was right. Suddenly, everything does look spooky.
There's a signal box. And the signal light is green. Someone must have been expecting us.
But they hadn't.
The points had been set in the wrong direction, but Stepney didn't realise this. Home, here we come, he thought. Then they approached an unknown area. The driver made a decision. It's best if we rest here until the fog clears. What are those strange sounds, wondered Stepney. Then the fog slowly lifted. Oh no, wailed Stepney. We're in the scrapyards. His driver and fireman went for help. Stepney was all alone, but not for long. Two diesels approached.
Got you this time, Stepney. You'll make very fine scrap indeed. Buffer him, Bert.
The diesels took him to the large smelter's shed.
Bye-bye, Stepney, said the diesel.
Stepney looked up. Above him was a huge grabber.
This engine's not for scrapping,
shouted Stepney. The grabber wasn't listening. But just as it was about to grab hold of him, it stopped. There stood the Fat Controller.
It's a good thing I've chosen to visit this yard tonight. Saving you from scrap is getting to be a habit, Stepney. Please stop it.
Yes, sir, but I have learned something.
What's that?
There's no place like home.
And that's exactly where you're going now.
Bluebells forever, sighed Stepney.